and politicians. Thank you.
Mr. Speaker.
Kanwal Bakshi.
Mr. Speaker, thank you for the opportunity to speak on the Members of Parliament Remuneration and Service Bill on its first reading. Sir, the legislation once again highlights this national-led government's commitment to transparency. This bill is a result of 2010 Law Commission report and repeals Civil List Act 1979. The Members of Parliament Remuneration and Service Bill empowers the Remuneration Authority to decide on the travel and accommodation entitlements for the MPs and ministers. Earlier, these decisions used to be undertaken by a minister responsible for ministerial services or the Parliament Speaker. The bill further adds to the steps that Honourable Speaker and Government has already taken to improve transparency around entitlements. In fact, this will create public confidence in the regime for setting entitlements for ministers and MPs. Furthermore, up until now, disclosure of MPs' travel and accommodation were voluntary. This bill will make it statutory requirement for all MPs and ministers to disclose their travel and accommodation. This bill doesn't just ask MPs to disclose their accommodation and travel expenses. It also ensures that in case they do not attend Parliament, they are penalized for it's not just for namesake. Earlier, the penalty for MP missing Parliament was $10 a day. This bill increases to $270 a day. It is important the public has confidence in the management for setting MPs and ministers' entitlement. These amendments, which put more power in hands of the independent decision maker, will improve the trust. The authority will have members with appropriate knowledge, skills, and experience to ensure that balance is maintained between zeroing misuse of taxpayers' money while ensuring that MPs and ministers have enough support to support their constituents and carry out parliamentary business. Mr. Speaker, this bill will provide that the Office of the Speaker will continue to make decision on MPs' entitlement to communication services, travel for inter-parliamentary exchange, and allocation of party and members' support funding. There is a groundswell out there to take action to improve transparency. The government is therefore listening to the people and taking action. Mr. Speaker, I support the Members of Parliament Remuneration and Services Bill on its first reading.
Nikki Wagner.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker.